How's it going, everyone? Today I'm going to be talking to you guys about optimizing the rendering of the search results. So basically the page that you're looking at right over here. So here we have a search query, Batman, and if I change to Superman, so you'll see, I misspelled that. Okay, so you see that the search result is being rendered over here. Now if you look at the log, you'll see that there's also an N plus one problem going on over here. Now, the real issue here is Elasticsearch actually finds those results, it also looks up the records in the database and then uses those records to render out the results. Now, here's a question. If we already indexed all this data into the Elasticsearch data store, why can't we just render directly from there and not have to go through the database? So let me show you what I mean over here. Over here, I have the Elasticsearch head loaded. And over here, you can see that the data that's actually been indexed into our data store. And you can see the string text over here, the synopsis is here, the name is here, the year, review, runtime. All this data is actually here in the data store. And when Elasticsearch searches for those results, it gets all of this data as well. So why can't we just use this? That's a very, very, very good observation on your part. So here's the thing. It's actually very easy, and I've actually implemented the solution to this. And I'm going to show you guys, you know, what it is, and then walk you through the whole process of cleaning all of this up. Okay, so I'm going to hit over to my console over here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch over to this branch where I have the solution already completed. So I switched over here. Now, if I hit reload in the browser, reload, this is now rendering with just Elasticsearch data store. Now, let's take a look at the difference. I'm going to go back into the console and you see here, there's no more active record query. It's 0.0 milliseconds. And it's now being completed in 98 milliseconds. So it's a lot faster. If we look back over here, it's about 122 and there is some data, hit in the database. Now it's not much because we're not rendering that many records, right? We're rendering just 10 results. But what if you wanted to render 50, even 100 results? This number can add up very quickly. But doing it this way, just loading it directly from the Elasticsearch data store and rendering that is much, much more efficient, and you don't have to hit two data stores. You just hit one, the Elasticsearch one. All right, so let's take a look at the code and what I did to fix all these problems. Okay, so I'm gonna switch back to the develop branch. So as you can see here, this is the before. All I did was I changed the word records into results. So I'm gonna switch back over here into the solution branch. So you can see here, it's changed into results. That's all I did. Now, here's the thing. I made a few more changes to the mapping as well, right? So if I take a look at the movie model, so I'm gonna switch back to the develop branch. So this is the before. All right, so we have a few things missing over here. As you can see, we're not indexing the runtime just yet. We add that in later. So I'm gonna switch back to the solution. Here we go. So you can see I added the runtime as well because we render the runtime on the results page. So we need to add that into the data store so we can directly get it from the data store. All right, so the biggest change is probably this file over here. Now before, so I'm gonna go to the before. Here we're just doing rendering movies. And by default, if you're using Active Record Collection, this takes care of itself, right? It's using some magic, some Rails magic to render all of this stuff. And here we have a div4 movie class panel. So the div4 movie, what it does is it basically renders each of these divs and then gives it the ID. So this movie underscore ID. So we probably have to replicate this ourselves if we use Elasticsearch data store, because it doesn't have the data store, Elasticsearch data store class does not have the same API as the active record models. So, all right, so I'm gonna switch back to the solution and you'll see what I did here. So all I did was I used content tag rather than a div for, and I added this ID over here with the movie.id. So this basically replicates div for what that we had before. And so this will basically make it all work exactly the same as before. Now in the index file, let's go and show you the before. So before it was just like this, and now it's like this, right? So that's pretty much it in terms of, you know, once you switch over from using Active Record to render the results to using Elasticsearch Data Store to render the results. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like this video if you like it. It really helps us out. Don't forget to subscribe. And we have some very exciting news for you guys as well. We are doing a brand new course for Ruby on Rails Fundamentals. So what we're doing is we're creating this course, and we have a video about it on our YouTube channel. And if you're interested, you can click on the link. I'm going to link it over here to check it out. And if you want to support us to make this course, to make this happen, go ahead and fill out your email. Showing your support really, really helps us out. And we're going to be selling the course for a very, very good price. It's going to be very cheap and accessible to everyone. This is going to be an online course. We're going to have videos that we're making right now up. And you can buy it for a very low price, and you will be able to learn all of the fundamentals of Ruby on Rails. All right, guys, I'm going to sign out. Thank you very much for watching. I will see you guys in the next one.